Before we get started, I wanted to say that while we're not doing science, we will continue to wear our face shields due to the current coronavirus pandemic. Hi, I'm Rachael. And hi, I'm Sarah, but I go by Dawson.
And we're
Staminists.
And hey, I'm Engie.
Today we're going to do math.
Magic math.
Dawson, have you ever tried those magic math problems where they tell you to choose a number and then you go through all these steps and they already know what number you're going to come up with?
No, that sounds so cool.
It is cool. And there are a lot of problems like this where you can find them on the internet. They'll tell you, you choose a number, and then you'll work through the steps, and then they already know what number you're going to come up with. I know, it's magic. Do you want to try one?
Ooh, yes, please.
All right, let's choose our markers. Okay, let's pick a number, any number between 1 and 10. I'm going to choose 6.
I'm going to choose 8.
Okay. All right, now let's multiply that number by 3. So I'm going to get 18.
And I should get 24.
Okay. So after that, we're going to take that number and we're going to add 6.
Okay. Should make 30 for me. What are you getting?
I'm getting 24. Okay, so now that we've got that number, we're going to take that number and we're going to divide it by 3.
Oh, that's easy for me. I make 10.
Okay, so I've got 8 and you've got 10. Mm-hmm. Okay, so now what we're going to do is our original number, we're going to subtract that from the number we just got. So I'm going to take 8 and subtract 6 and I get 2.
Oh, so I'll do 10 minus 8. Mm-hmm. So that will give me 2.
Wait, so how do we both get 2?
What?
No, it's magic math. Well, math is just a language we use in science to define patterns or irregularities that happen in the world around us.
Well, what pattern did we use for that first example?
That's a really good question. So what we were working off of was multiples of 3.
We really were.
We were. So let's work through it so everyone can see.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, so let's work off that example that we just did to explain.
Okay.
So I started with the number 6, and we'll work through that one. All right, I'll choose a marker. Okay, the black marker.
I'm going to do blue.
Okay. All right, so let's write 6 down.
6. And I'm going to make them circles. 4, 5, 6.
Okay, so the first thing that we did is we multiplied 6 times 3, which equals 18.
17, 18.
All right. Well, it looks like you've got 3 rows of 6.
Oh, I do.
Which, that's divided by 3.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the next step that we did is we added 6 onto this 18.
Okay, so we added 6 more. 6. So then.
Okay, so we are going to do that. We're going to take 24 divided by 3, and we get 8.
So let's see, we got one group here and here. So there's 2 groups of 3 in every row. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 groups.
Perfect.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so the last thing that we did is we took this number that we just got, mm-hmm. 8, and we subtracted 6 from it.
Okay, 8 minus 6. So that would be minus these 4 and minus another 2. So I'm left with 2 circles.
2 circles, and I have the number 2.
Awesome.
So what we can see here with your circles is that it didn't matter what number we started with, we were always going to end up with two circles, because what we did is we multiplied something by three, and then we added six, which is just two.
That's just two times
three. Times three. Excellent. And then we divided that by three.
Which reverses this one.
Which reverses that one. So all we're left with is this little bit right here.
Oh, yeah. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. So you're always going to get two, regardless of which number, ever number you started with. So it doesn't matter what number you start with. You'll always end up with two.
Okay, that's really cool. Can we do another one?
You want to do another magic math problem?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. Okay, for this one, what we're going to do is we're going to take any three, like, repeated three-digit number between 111 and 999. What would you like?
I'm going to do 333.
Okay, well, I was going to do 444. Okay, let's choose marker.
Do this one.
Okay, so let's write, I'm going to write 444.
333.
And this one's pretty easy. It's only a two-step, but that doesn't mean that it's going to be easy to figure out. So the first thing we're going to do is I'm going to sum 4 plus 4 plus 4, and you'll sum
3 plus 3 plus 3.
Perfect. And I get 12?
9.
Okay. So the next step is we're going to take our original number, and we're going to divide it by the number we just got.
Okay.
So I've got 4 plus 4 and 4 divided by 12, and that equals
37. Wait a second. How'd you get 37?
We got the same number.
What's the secret here?
So what we noticed is that we both got the same number, 37.
Mm-hmm.
So if we take 37 and multiply it by a number to get 111, we've got 37 times 3 equals 111. We've got 37 times 6 equals 222. And 37 times 9 equals 333. And 37 times 12 equals 444. And those were the ones that we did. But do you notice anything about these particular numbers?
Yeah, they're all divisible by 3.
They are divisible by 3. So what's 3 divided by 3?
3 divided by 3 is 1.
Okay. What about 6?
6 divided by 3 is 2.
Okay. 9?
9 divided by 3 is 3.
Okay. 12?
12 divided by 3 is 4.
And then we'll just do the last one. What is 15?
15 divided by 3 is 5.
Okay. So what I'm seeing here is actually what's happening. I'm going to erase these numbers. And we've got 37 times 3 times 1 equals 111.
Mm-hmm.
And 37 times 3 times 2 equals 222. And 37 times 3 times 3, equals 333. And 37 times 3 times 4 equals 444. And 37 times 3 times 5 equals 555.
555.
Isn't that crazy? We get 111 comes from 3 times 1 times 37. And 222 comes from 2 times 3 times 37. And the list goes down, all the way down to 999. Well, now that we've already done two examples, let's try to do one on our own.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right, let's choose marker. Okay, the first step is to choose a number between 1 and 10.
Okay. You better not pick my number.
I know. Okay, next step is to take that number and multiply it by 2.
Okay.
Okay, so take that number and add 4. Okay, so take that number and divide it by 2.
Okay.
Okay. Now take that number
mm-hmm.
and you're going to subtract 2.
Is that the final answer?
That is your final answer.
Okay. I got 6.
I got 5.
What?
Well, how did we get the different numbers?
Oh, it's what we started with.
It's the number that I started with.
That's pretty cool.
I wonder what that means. Can you figure it out?
How did they do that? Do you know how?
If you have any questions, please email us at the links that pop up.
And now that you know the secret, please feel free to be a magician to all your friends and family, and even watch some of those other videos and find the pattern within those.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
See you next time.
Thanks, everyone. See you next time.
Okay, I'm sorry. I always mess up. Okay. And we're starting. And we're...